Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and Merry Christmas to you all.
Merry Christmas!
Okay, we can do better than that. Merry Christmas! It's good to see you here this afternoon at what has become, at least for me, an integral part of the Christmas season, and a wonderful way to start out. I know the retail stores have been playing Christmas music for more than a month now, but that really doesn't count. This is what starts the season for me. I've been asked to make a few announcements before I pray, so let me check and see. First one is, this is very important. Will whoever parked the red sleigh and the eight reindeer please move that vehicle to the roof? You're blocking the fire lane. Okay. We do, of course, have to make a few concessions to the pandemic that seems to be all around us, henceforth the masks. And it has been impossible for social distancing to take place. So what I would like you all to do now is take a very deep breath, okay? Pull in a nice deep breath. You got it? Okay, now hold that for the remainder of the program. And you will understand, finally, what they mean by a blue Christmas. You do that. But on a more serious note, we do have some announcements. I would like to remind you that there will not be offering passed from hand to hand due to COVID. But of course, this is a church service, so there will be an offering collected. The plates are right down there in the main aisle on a stool. And we do ask that you donate generously to that. That helps fund music for this program and other items for the West Prairie Ministerium, who is the sponsor of this program this afternoon. And also, I'm asked to remind you that there will be refreshments downstairs, and you are all invited to partake of those. So, let's take a moment to bow in prayer. Heavenly Father, this is a very difficult time on earth. We are surrounded by turmoil. We are in the midst of the pandemic, and every day we hear of new cases among family, friends, people in our community. Fear fills our heart with uncertainty. We don't know what the future holds for us all. And as the popular song goes, Lord, we need a little Christmas. We need to hear the message that the angels gave to the shepherds once again. We need to feel in our hearts the joy that is Christmas. This day we have 31 angels assembled to sing to us as the angels did that day. And we ask your blessing upon them as they sing. We thank you for moving in their hearts, bringing them to this day through all the hard days of practice and through all the uncertainty of this pandemic. Lord, we thank you that so many were able to be here to hear this message. And we ask that it fill our hearts and set our season of Christmas and joy on the right track. Let us truly understand through the message brought here today what it meant so long ago to the shepherds and the kings and all who gathered at the manger. Lord, I pray this today sincerely in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. If you were looking in your program, you probably noticed that Susan Hench was supposed to be a part of this trio. And as you well know, sickness just is around this time, and especially with COVID and everything else. And Susan was sick last week, and she's a nurse. And she said, I just have a really bad flu. She wasn't sure if it was COVID or not, but she still didn't want to take a chance. So she called Mondi up. So Mondi, in about 4 days, was able to learn Susan's part. And we also appreciate Judy Lamb coming in. And Judy played the piano, where Mondi was supposed to play the piano. So everybody got shuffled around. So would you one more time give a nice round of applause to the ladies, Judy? It is so good to see all of you. You know, we missed last year, and you know, when this whole COVID thing hit, there was a lot of discussion, should we, shouldn't we, should, you know, and we finally didn't. But I missed all of you. There have been a lot of changes. 2 years ago when we did the last one, this jacket actually buttoned. It doesn't anymore. But that's what stand-in does for you. It's either eat or eat. So anyway, we are excited to be here this afternoon. I did want to just point out one more thing, and that is we ask you that you would hold your applause until the end of the cantata. You know, you're always very gracious with your applause, and the cantata tells a complete story as we go along. Also, one more announcement, and that is our pastor was supposed to be here today. He's a new pastor, too. He came last year about the same time as Pastor Andrew did, and he was so excited because I've been telling him about this group, and he ended up with the bug, and he has three little kiddos, and so they just bring him home from school, and so he apologized. He was supposed to be here for the benediction, but Pastor Andrew is going to handle that. So at this point, we're going to ask you to stand up, stretch your legs a little bit, and join us in singing It Came Upon a Midnight Clear, number 38. That's in the blue hymnal.
Angels bending near the earth to touch. Christmas is a season of joy and glory. But for Mary and Joseph, the journey began with surprise, danger, and uncertainty. It took them from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem, to the darkness of a stable and the wonder of a miraculous birth. On the hills nearby, shepherds fell in terrified awe at the angelic announcement that a Savior had been born for them. And so began their late night journey to find him.
Oh,
something momentous had taken place. Bringing precious gifts, they journeyed to find him.
We bring things of Orient art, bearing gifts we travel so far.
Took place so that one day we could know Emmanuel, God with us.
Joseph, your angels
the story of the birth of Jesus has been retold for over 2,000 years. We picture the poor carpenter Joseph and his virgin bride, the inn that had no room, the baby sleeping in a feeding trough. And though we're certain that the Father had planned every moment, we look with wonder and say, how strange that God's only begotten Son would come the way he did.
I'm sure he must have been surprised at where this road had taken him. 'Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel come to life. And Joseph said, why? I'm just a simple man of trade.
When the shepherds rushed into Bethlehem that night, what did they expect to find? Could they have imagined the Prince of Heaven in a place. Still, they knew enough to fall in worship at the sight of the baby who was Christ the Lord.
Still the greatest story.
started in the sleepy little town of Bethlehem was only the beginning of the Savior's amazing story. He would be worshipped and hunted, received and rejected, loved and hated, celebrated and betrayed. One day he would be abandoned, arrested, beaten, and crucified. But the greatest miracle of all is how far he would go to redeem us.
Thank you.
leading us in this beautiful cantata. And I pray that you are full of the joy of Christ's birth and that you leave here in joy and share it with the world. Go in peace.
Join us, please rise and sing number 23 in the two hymnals, Angels We Have Heard on High. Thank you.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.